Hello, my name is Dr. Sourav Das. I'm a consultant psychiatrist with Somnos Sleep Clinic. I'm also attached as a visiting consultant with Medica Super Speciality Hospital, Kolkata and Iris Multispeciality Hospital, Kolkata. I work as a consultant psychiatrist dealing with various kinds of patients, including those suffering from schizophrenia. And I do deal with general adult psychiatry, particularly those who have various kinds of psychotic disorders and addictive disorders in my routine clinical practice. To discuss about how schizophrenia is diagnosed, we first have to understand that there is no single test like an MRI or an EEG or a blood test which can definitively diagnose schizophrenia. As of now, we do not have any that kind of technology. Schizophrenia is always diagnosed clinically. There are different sets of criteria. Some criteria have been proposed by the World Health Organization in their coding book called ICD or International Classification of Diseases. Another set of diagnostic criteria is given by the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual version 5, currently given by the American Psychiatric Association. So there are various criteria which a patient has to match in order to be diagnosed him or her as schizophrenia, and this diagnosis is always done by a psychiatrist who is trained in the diagnosis and management of schizophrenia. However, in a person with schizophrenia, there are certain functional changes of the brain which can be obtained by certain amount of functional neuroimaging testing, like PET scan, like SPECT scan, like functional MRI. But these are not routinely used in clinical practice, firstly because they are expensive, secondly there is absolutely no need of doing such kind of testing in the general routine clinical practice in the treatment of a person with schizophrenia, because we know these tests, when done in research groups, research populations, it has been seen that a person who is having schizophrenia has so and so things higher in their brain or so things lower in the brain. So that does not have any significance in diagnosing one single individual with schizophrenia. So to sum it up, schizophrenia is diagnosed clinically always. Now the question comes, when a person is having schizophrenia, do they know it that they have schizophrenia? It's a very difficult question to answer actually, because the answer is both yes and no. In many cases, a person can feel that they are not able to think clearly, that something is wrong with them, and things that are happening to them is always correct. Sometimes they can feel that they can hear voices which are actually not true, but at the same time, the voices seem to be very true when they are coming to them. So they have some idea that something is going on which is not correct. They sometimes can seek help, and when diagnosed and told that they are having schizophrenia, a lot of them actually choose to accept it and become supportive and cooperative in treatment process. On the other hand, someone who have very severe symptoms and are completely lost to touch with reality, they find it very difficult to understand. In fact, they have what we call as poor insight. They do not know that they are having any symptoms or anything is abnormal with them. To them, the voices coming are very real, the suspicions are very real, the whatever things are happening to around them are very real. They do not understand that this is happening because of certain brain circuitry and brain chemical malfunctioning, and as a result they do not feel or they do not know that they are having schizophrenia, but their family members and neighbors and others who are observing their speech and behavior and thoughts and action, they understand that something is grossly abnormal. However, when these patients who do not have this idea or knowledge that they are having schizophrenia, once they are brought into treatment and are treated successfully, after a point of time when the symptoms start reducing, most of them do come to realize that these were an abnormal period which happened due to an illness called schizophrenia, and now they are getting treatment and they are much better, and they gradually get the feeling that things are becoming better now, and then they realize that they were having schizophrenia. So that is all for today. We'll meet again. Thank you.